It's just an infection in my lungs. And it just keeps me from doing some certain stuff that a normal person would do.
12-year-old Abby has cystic fibrosis. And like many with the condition, she's more prone to bacterial infection in her lungs.
We need to use strong antibiotics, and that course usually is about 10 to 14 days.
Dr. Dev Singh has been part of Abby's medical team for a decade, but the bacteria in his patients are becoming more resistant to antibiotics.
You know, the IV antibiotics aren't really working, so we've sort of got to try something else that's going to keep her healthier for the future.
For instance, bacteriophage, should we give it a try to see if we can actually get rid of this bacteria in her chest?
Bacteriophages, you know, bacteria eaters, that's where the name comes from, are viruses that prey on bacteria. They're probably the most numerous and diverse life form on Earth.
Professor John Iredell is head of the Centre for Infectious Diseases and Microbiology at Westmead.
If your enemy's enemy is your friend, then bacterial viruses are your friend when you have an infection.
And finding these viruses is fairly simple.
So if you are worried about an infection that normally lives in the human gut, you look in the human gut or in sewage. If you are looking for a bug that has opportunistically got into a chest but normally lives in the soil or a river, you go to a river or the dirt to find it.
John's team match phages with superbugs. It's part of a global fight to control infections against which antibiotics are increasingly powerless.
Predictions are that within a generation, if the trajectory doesn't change, then it will be the leading cause of death, more than cancer, more than heart disease, number one cause of death globally. So it's really a major health and economic emergency.
Once in your body, phages will attach to a targeted bacterial cell. They then inject their own gene material into the host. The phage replicates inside, eventually rupturing the cell. The new phages repeat the pattern, killing off the problem bacteria.
At the moment, the main demand is people who have just, you know, really failed conventional therapy.
The team at Westmead has saved dozens of lives already by working with hospitals around the country. But this isn't a new science.
I think our Georgian and Polish colleagues precede us by many, many decades. It's a routine therapy, so they've got this enormous experience.
In Georgia, patients are regularly prescribed phage therapies instead of antibiotics.
And clearly there's a lot of different bacteria in the world that could cause an infection. That means you need to have a lot of different phages.
And the team at Westmead is leading international efforts to link up phage libraries.
We've shown that you can make a phage and send it anywhere in the world on a jet now, and it's fine when it gets there. Well, why not just connect all the repositories in the world so that we can just exchange them?
It was John's team who received Abby's bacteria from Dev.
And from there, we got about 6 bacteriophages that showed promising results, and we picked the best one for her.
Abby is the first patient in the phage trial. Every 6 months, she spends 2 weeks in hospital for treatment.
She usually comes in around about the 80% and gets her lung capacity gets up to about 100 when we leave after a tune-up.
When it's low, it's like hard to breathe and it feels like you're kind of stuck in one place and the lungs just feel really tight.
Abby has to travel 700 kilometres to get here from her home in Lightning Ridge in northwest New South Wales.
I work full-time and single mother, it's for 2 weeks it's quite hectic.
While it's only the first of 3 phases of testing and nothing is official, the phages appear to be doing what they're supposed to do, killing the bacteria.
It's amazing that it's working, so, like, yeah, we're pretty stoked to be able to have a go at it firsthand, I suppose.
Perfect.
Wonderful.
Eventually, over time, once we prove that it's safe, it is efficient, we want to see people or living with CF being able to do this treatment even at home.
Wow.
It's really game-changing stuff, especially as someone, as a person with disability, I was a young kid with disability. Just medical advances make life so much better. Mm-hmm. And the investment for that young girl, you can see in her face how much it means to have another option rather than things that don't always work. And, yeah, I mean, I'm lucky to be born now. I really am. I don't think I'll be doing what I'm doing if I was born, you know, 30 years ago and things like that. So it is beautiful to see stories like that.